amount of suitcases we can take. We need to lug less luggage to the airport.
Yes, something I try to do every trip but doesn't seem to work. Here to tell us more about traveling light and traveling right is Dr. Audrey Guskey from Duquesne University with our Consumer Tuesday report. And Audrey, I have to say it is the one thing that eludes me. Every time I attempt to pack light, because of the restrictions, it's impossible. So what kind of tips can you give us to help out?
Well, Sunny, you are exactly right. It is a huge issue for travelers nowadays because you are really limited in the amount of luggage you can take, and it depends upon which airline. If you're traveling United or US Air, you're only allowed to have two carry-ons. If you're traveling Southwest, which is surprising, the economic airline, the cheaper airline, allows you to bring three luggage that you can, you know, check. But you have to be very, very careful because of the size and the weight. If the luggage is 62 inches or larger, or if it weighs over 50 pounds, what tends to happen is you're going to be charged $40 to $50. One thing you want to keep in mind for carry-ons is the rule 311. What you've got is you're allowed to have 3 ounces of a liquid in one quart Ziploc bag and one per person. As we all know, with the terrorist threats that we had about a year ago in August 10th, people were limited. At one point we were banned for all of our liquids, and now you are allowed to take, as I said, 311, 3 ounces of a liquid in a one quart bag, and that's only one per person. So at least they're trying to balance security with human needs of people.
You know what, that's very important that you mentioned the whole 311 rule, because last time I was in Chicago, purchased a gift set, and it was brand new, hadn't been opened, but because it was in my carry-on,
had to throw it away.
We had to throw it away.
Yeah, and at least in the beginning of those restrictions, Audrey, that was certainly the case with a lot of people. So that's a good thing to keep in mind.
Yeah. Absolutely.
311. Now, what about some tips as far as when you get to your destination, if you have any trouble retrieving your luggage? Mm-hmm.
Well, you have to be careful with that, because if obviously your luggage does not show up, they have given you some options as well. But let's look at some tips we've got from if you're traveling and what you should pack and not pack. We have check what the hotel will provide. If they're giving you shampoo, they're giving you conditioners, they're giving you hair dryers, they're giving you bathrobes, of course don't bring that stuff. Always bring a lightweight duffel because you can put all those treasures that you've purchased. However, if you purchase too many things, what you want to do is take those souvenirs and ship them, so that way you don't have to deal with them, and it's going to be much cheaper if you do FedEx or something like that. You also want to have a change of clothes in case your luggage does not make it. And a good tip, if you're traveling with somebody else, a child, a spouse, a friend, put some of your clothes in his or hers and then put someone else's in, so that you don't have to worry. Photocopy everything, so that way, as far as documents, in case you lose your passport, and always check the bag claims. As you're giving away your luggage to the airline, make sure it's going to the right destination area.
Yeah, that's always helpful. I think we've all been in situations where the luggage is delayed or doesn't arrive at all in some unfortunate cases.
Oh, boy.
Yep, good tips. Audrey, we're going to be traveling a lot this summer, so we definitely will use the information. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Very appropriate for July the 4th coming up. Thank you. And don't forget, Audrey is with